Well, here's how to use SimBrief so you can get maximum enjoyment out of the Zibo 737 in your X-Plane 11 simulator. First, click on New Flight. Enter the start and end airports. Here it's HSSS to HAAB. SimBrief fills in an alternate. Please note I'm using pounds, that's set in my profile. Next, you need to insert the airframe. Change that to Boeing 737-800. That done, come into the cost index, a CI, which I set to 14, which I believe Southwest Airlines uses. Now, once the cost index is set, you get your start and finish landing runways, and I enter a reserve fuel of 1.5, which is 1,500 pounds. There's some additional information below there, not needed now. And you can look at a suggested routing that SimBrief has provided. There are others you can select, but I'm going to go with the default. The first and last entries here look like SIDs and STARS. Click on Generate OFP and Yes to let it destroy your old flight plan. Okay, here's the plan. First, we look at the flight path, showing the origin, the destination, and the alternate way over in Djibouti somewhere. This scrollable box below has key information. First, the cruising altitude of 370 flight level or 37,000 feet. Then further down here is the pounds of fuel we'll need to load in the aircraft. And then below that, we have the actual path, the route, which shows you the starting runway, the landing runway, and the route. Further down, we're going to find the payload, the total payload that we need to load, and I believe it's showing 35,900 pounds here. It's shown as 35.9. There's useful information below, like different charts with winds at different altitudes, and most usefully, right at the bottom, is your flight level and the terrain underneath the aircraft. Now, sometimes this is shown right to left, so be careful. This one is showing left to right. And finally, we download this flight plan by clicking the X-Plane download, and it goes off into the download folder that you can move into X-Plane 11's output folder for FMS plans and load directly onto the aircraft. Now you can copy and paste that route from here into SkyVector. And here you can see right near the Horn of Africa is the flight path from Khartoum to Addis Ababa.